Do you know how to solve an inequality that has multiplication or division in it? Let's take a look at one. Here's a simple one to start. 5x is greater than or equal to 30. We want to figure out which values, when they're substituted in for x, will make this inequality a true statement. To do that, we're going to use the inverse of whatever operation is present in the inequality. This inequality already has multiplication in it, so we're going to use the inverse and we're going to divide both sides by 5. We're going to get the x alone. 5 divided by 5 cancels, bring down the x. X is greater than or equal to 30 divided by 5, which is 6. If we choose a value that is greater than or equal to 6, that will make this inequality into a true statement. Now let's look at a simple one using division. X divided by 4 is less than 2. We want to figure out what values, when we substitute in for x, will make this a true statement. There's division in the inequality, so we're going to use the inverse, which is multiplication. We're going to multiply both sides by 4. These 4s cancel, bring down the x. X is less than 2 times 4, which is 8. When we substitute a value that is less than 8 into this inequality, it will make it into a true statement. Sometimes you're also going to see inequalities that have fractions or decimals in them. Let's take a look at how to work with one of those. 4/5 x is less than or equal to 20. Now I want to get x alone on the left side of the inequality. So to do that, I'm going to multiply by the inverse of this fraction so that it will cancel. Multiplying by this reciprocal will have me have a product of 1. The 5s cancel, the 4s cancel, I can bring down the x. Now since I did this on the left side, I'm going to have to do it over here too. So I'm going to multiply 20 times 5 over 4. Now, let's bring down this inequality symbol before we do anything else. Now here I'm going to put 20 over 1. And when I multiply, I have 100 over 4. 4 goes into 100 25 times. So x is less than or equal to 25. If I substitute a value into this inequality that is less than or equal to 25, it will make the inequality a true statement. Let's take a look at another one. 1/2 x is greater than 6. Again, I want to get x alone. So I'm going to multiply by the reciprocal of the 1/2, and I'm going to do that over here too. Here, these cancel. Bring down the x. X is greater than 12. Any value that I substitute into this inequality that is greater than 12 will make it a true statement. Let's take a look at one with a decimal. 2.4x is greater than or equal to 14.4. I want to get x alone, so I'm going to divide by 2.4, and I'm going to do that over here as well. These cancel, bring down the x. X is greater than or equal to 14.4 divided by 2.4, which is 6. This is my answer, and my work is now complete.